hump. Skip seconds. Skip dessert. Skip, skip, skip to my lube. Don't skip breakfast. Drink H2O. Lower your sodium. Raise the roof. Shake your booty. Stock up on vegetables. And don't forget to eat them. Search We Can online to find more ways you and your family can get healthy together. A message from the Ad Council, HHS, and NIH's We Can program.
Go, Caleb!
Come on, hit a homer, Jesse!
Let's go, guys!
Hey, did you guys know that kids who play sports earn more money when they grow up?
Of course. I knew that.
Hey, did you guys know that kids who read books have a bigger vocabulary?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Wow, jinx. Did you guys know that friendly children have more friends?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's true. I knew that. Did you guys know that winter babies are better at music?
Everyone knows that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's pretty obvious.
Yeah,
yeah.
Obvious. Oh, hey, guys, did you know that most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Huh. I didn't know that.
I'm pretty sure I knew that.
I'm pretty sure you didn't.
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right car seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo. Smile.
Smile, buddy.
Come on. Smile. Oh, honey. He's still not smiling.
Maybe he's not a
smiler. Yeah. Maybe he's just not a happy
baby. Maybe he's just being a boy. You know how boys are.
Or maybe he's teething. Oh, poor baby. I think his gums hurt.
Maybe he's just tired.
Or maybe his tummy hurts. He didn't eat that much.
Maybe he's not ticklish.
You think maybe he's scared of the dog?
Maybe he'll outgrow it. Maybe it's a phase. Maybe he just doesn't like smiling.
Maybe he has autism, and we can definitely do something to help.
Maybe is all you need to find out more about autism. No big, joyful smiles by 6 months is one early sign. Learn the others at autismspeaks.org/signs or see a doctor today for an autism screening. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better. And it can make a lifetime of difference. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council.
My name is Dale Pazinski, and this is how I live United. I volunteer with United Way, helping the homeless in my community by teaching computer skills and helping them build a basic resume to save on their very own USB drive. It's huge when somebody says, "Hey man, that job that you helped me apply for, I got it." My name is Dale Pazinski. I help people achieve financial independence. So I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer, live united. Go to liveunited.org, brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. At 6, I make his breakfast. Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. At 6, I make his breakfast. At 7, I shower. Every day I wake up...
For those caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love. Visit aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
So, who's going to do what? Flashlights?
Nowhere to be found.
Emergency supply kits?
Not packed.
What about blankets?
We have an old towel.
Cell phones?
May not work.
Emergency water?
Not a drop.
Perfect. We all know where we're meeting if we're separated.
The library.
Aunt Joan's house.
The bus stop.
And I'll be waiting here wondering where you all are. Great. It sounds like we don't have a plan.
Winging It is not an emergency plan. Make sure your kids know what to do during an emergency. Who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Back live at Abe Lemons Arena, the Stars lead it at the break 55-43 over UCO. Taking a look at the halftime stats now for UCO, Mylon Jones has 15 points. Cal Andrews, Jared Bairstow, Seth Heckert, 7 apiece for the Broncos. Four players with 2 points for UCO. Jared Bairstow and Seth Heckert, 4 rebounds apiece for the Broncos. Stars out rebounding UCO 24-20. 2 assists by Seth Heckert leads the way in that category. 2 steals by Jared Bairstow. 5 steals as a team for UCO. 2 block shots. 9 turnovers. 6 assists on 14 made baskets. 14 of 32 is 44% shooting. They're 4 of 12 from 3-point range and 12 out of 17 from the foul line. A good first half for OCU offensively. They shot 51% from the floor, 53% from 3. They got 4 threes and 15 points from R.J. McGee in the first half. Derrance Benome, Gary Englund, 8 apiece. 7 for Ivan Jelicic and Theron Chilton. 8 rebounds by Gary England. He's been all over the place for OCU since coming in midway through the first half. Dema Sine has 4. Ivan Jelicic with 3. Dema already over his rebound total from the Midwestern game, I believe. That is true. He had just 2 boards in that game. Plagued with foul trouble against Midwestern. Stars got 4 assists from Jameel Donovan. They had 4 players with 2 assists. 2 steals by Theron Chilton. They had 2 steals in all. Those were the only 2. 1 blocked shot, that came from Dema. 7 turnovers by the Stars. They had 15 assists on 22 made baskets. 22 of 43 is 51% shooting from the floor. They were 8 of 15 from 3-point range. And 3 out of 7 from the foul line. That's got to improve. Again, the halftime score, 55-44 OCU over UCO. We'll step aside. We'll come back with more in a moment on OCUSports.com.
Unexpected reactions to smart financial decisions brought to you by FeedThePig.org.
Well, I finally did it. I opened a 401k.
So you're giving up, just like that?
Giving up on what?
On getting an inheritance from a distant relative.
Don't you think if there were a billionaire in the family, we'd know about it by now?
Listen to me. We are one phone call away from riding horses on our own private polo grounds. One call from christening yachts, having a butler, using summer as a verb.
How do you figure?
Look, everyone's got a rich uncle somewhere. It's statistics. So the best thing you can do is just prepare for the inevitable.
Right. Which is why I thought maybe it would be smart to take control of my finances. You know, start using a budget, get out of debt, set some retirement goals.
Budgets? Debt? You watch your mouth. Retirement shouldn't be a goal for us. It should be a way of life.
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind. Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org. This message brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs and the Ad Council.
Hi, I'm LeVar Burton, and I'm proud to be a book person. How do I choose a book? Sometimes it's the cover, sometimes it's the title. I guess I'm pretty visual. If a book's really impressing me and the writing is really good, I will peek and see what the last paragraph is, because the endings of books should rock you. I am a book person, and if you're a book person too, read to a child and spark a lifetime of ambition. Join me at bookpeopleunite.org, because reading is fundamental. A public service announcement brought to you by Reading is Fundamental, Library of Congress, and the Ad Council.
So, I'm a dog, and I just got adopted by this new human guy, and I'm starting to wonder how he got along without me. I mean, okay, something as simple as walking around the block. He's got this leash thing, and he puts me on one end and him on the other, and I'm just taking him around. I think he's afraid of getting lost. Without that leash and me guiding him along, I don't think he'd find his way back home. But it's kind of cute.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
My name is Ruth Rusey. I'm a retired teacher. I'm 91 years old, and this is how I live United. I say retired, but not really. Once a week, I read books to children as part of United Way's education program. Reading to a child creates links between language and literacy. It creates a bond between grown-up and child. And believe it or not, it prepares them for a better academic future. Oh, we read about frogs and flies and pigs with wings, all sorts of juicy stuff. It's a joy to watch all those little faces. I figure I have the time and they have the need. And I've always believed that if we're not here to help each other, then what are we here for, really? My name is Ruth Rusey. I help kids prepare to succeed in school. So I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer, live United. Go to liveunited.org. Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
Hey, sweetie, what's going on?
Well, honey, I have some news.
Okay, what?
All that training paid off. I got the job.
Oh, I knew you would get it. So when do you start?
When you donate stuff to Goodwill, you help provide job training for people right here in your community. Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs. Find your nearest donation center at goodwill.org. A message from Goodwill and the Ad Council.
There's hundreds of fun and simple things you and your family can do to live a healthier lifestyle. Here's 20 of them. Eat less, eat slower, eat smarter, eat your fruits and veggies, stop eating before you're full, up your fiber, lower your calories, get off the bus early, do some gardening, do jumping jacks, take the stairs, take one, not two, take on a new sport, take a long walk home, walk instead of drive, bend, stretch, reach for the stars, climb the monkey bars, skip the fudge bars. Search We Can online to find more ways you and your family can get healthy together. A message from the Ad Council, HHS, and NIH's We Can program.
Well, I finally did it. My student loan is totally paid off.
What? What about our plan to win the lottery and start living? You know, travel the world on matching yachts, wear enough jewelry to require a bodyguard, vacation on the French Riviera, and then buy it.
You know we're never going to win the lottery, right?
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind. Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org. This message brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs, the Oklahoma Society of CPAs, and the Ad Council.
This is a guided meditation on...
Back live at Abe Lemons Arena. The Stars lead at 55-44 at halftime. Apologize, we had a problem with our audio feeding into the video today. NoSUSports.com. Our audio feed has been working, but the video attached to it, or the audio attached to the video, is offline. I believe we have that fixed at this point. Good first half by OCU, shooting over 50% from the floor. Led by R.J. McGee, who had 15 points. UCO comes out with Mylon Jones, Seth Heckert, Trey Jordan, Jared Bairstow, and Garen Wright. OCU goes with the original starting five, Jameel Donovan, Terrence Benome, Dorian Giger, Demasene, R.J. McGee. Dorian did not play much in the first half, scored 2 points, but got two early fouls, had to sit out. Terrence will throw it in, does so into the backcourt to Jameel Donovan, and the second half is underway. Jameel throws it to Terrence Benome, outside left, left low post to Dema, turns, faces, shoots a high arcing eight-footer, and scores! Second basket for Dema. 57-44, OCU. Seth Heckert with a behind-the-back dribble into the front court. Backs away against Jameel Donovan. Man-to-man defense. Hands it off to Garen Wright. Comes around the screen. Dribbles off to his left. Now explodes to the left. Layup no. Foul called as Garen Wright hit the deck. And the foul will be on Dema. That is his second. First team foul the second half. Garen Wright will be at the line for two. He had 2 points at the foul line in the first half. 2 for 4 foul shooting. Garen Wright, 6'4", 210, a redshirt freshman from Putnam City High School. Foul shot is on the way, and it's a brick that goes in. Clanged hard off the back of the rim and died on the heel of the iron and dropped through. Wright will have one more. On the way, and that one spins out, no good, halfway down and back out, and Dorian Giger rebounds for OCU. Here's Terrence Benome into the front court, comes across the screen to his left into a double team. Now that double team dissolves. Terrence looks for somewhere to go as he's terminated the dribble out to Dema ahead of the circle, and Dema has it stolen away by Garen Wright. Wright the other way, all the way to the bucket, layup good. 57-47, OCU on top, 19:05 to play in the game. Jameel Donovan hesitates off to his left, throws it back to the right to R.J. McGee. R.J. lobs it into Dorian. Dorian had his shot go off the bottom of the backboard, but rebounded by Jameel Donovan. Out left side, Terrence Benome. Three-pointer is good. Terrence Benome has 11 points. 60-47. OCU on top. Seth Heckert drives right, shoots the follow-away layup, missed. Rebound off the floor taken by Dema, who had it originally and got it back. Here comes R.J. McGee down the right side of the floor. Skip pass left side, Jameel Donovan. Three-pointer. Bingo! It rattled around the rim and in. That's the second three of the game for Jameel Donovan. And it's 63-47. This is OCU's biggest lead. 18-16 to play. A drive all the way to the bucket and a layup that's good by Marlon Jones. He has 17 points. He's been the offense for UCO tonight. 63-49 OCU. Jameel Donovan crosses over to his right. Right corner it goes to Terrence Benome. Top of the key to Dema. Dema fakes left, dribbles right, kicks it back out to R.J. McGee, left side. R.J. measures, fakes the shot. He fakes right, dribbles left, whips it inside, left foot post to Dema. Dema turns, and he is going to be fouled from behind, apparently, by Trey Jordan. That'll be his third and the team's first of the half. That'll reset the shot clock. 17:51 to play in the game, and R.J. McGee will inbound left baseline underneath us. So did Dorian Gigger, top of the key. They leave him alone. He shoots for three, and he nails it. Dorian can shoot the three, and he proved it there. He's got 5 points, 66-49 OCU. Jones on the dribble against Terrence Benome, explodes off to his right. Terrence fouls him on the way to the bucket, didn't give him space to turn the corner. And for Terrence Benome, that's his first, the team's second of the half. Gary Englund is in, Dema is out. Cal Andrews is in for UCO. Trey Jordan is out. UCO will inbound, right baseline underneath. Some confusion as to the previous substitution for UCO. They have Garen Wright, Cal Andrews, Jared Bairstow, Seth Heckert, and Marlon Jones on the floor. Stars have R.J. McGee, Gary Englund, Terrence Benome, Jameel Donovan, and Dorian Gigger. Now UCO will inbound, lob inbound for Cal Andrews, head of the circle, gives it to Seth Heckert, he fakes a pass, throws it left side to Bairstow. Bairstow looking for somewhere to go, hands it off to Jones, fakes the shot, takes two dribbles, leans in and draws a foul on a 17-footer by R.J. McGee. That is his third and the team's third. And so foul shots, I believe, coming for Jones. He'll have two, as that was not a three-point shot. Alan Jones will have two foul shots here. Two for four foul shooting in the first half, and he makes this one off the heel of the rim and in. Jones has 18 points. No other player for UCO has more than seven at this point. 66-50, OCU on top of the Broncos of UCO. 17:28 to play in the second half as Jones shoots the second foul shot, makes that one as well. RJ stays in the game with his three fouls and 15 points. Had four threes in the first half. Now he explodes underneath pass to Dorian Gigger, and he's hammered going up by Seth Heckert, and Dorian Gigger will shoot two. For Heckert, that's his second, the team's second. And Dorian Gigger, the 6'5", 205-pound sophomore from Moore High School, south of Oklahoma City, shoots the first foul shot and makes it. Dorian has 6 points. He shoots the second. Missed that one off the back of the rim. Rebound tapped high in the air twice. Bairstow has it for UCO, and here come the Broncos. Heckert with a diagonal dribble into the front court. Stops. Looks for somewhere to go. Hands it off to Jones. Guarded closely by Terrence Benome. Drives off to his left. They're going to get a hand check foul on Terrence Benome. That'll be his second of the half. And the fourth already in this half for OCU. UCO will inbound right baseline underneath. Mop up some moisture on the floor first. 17:06 left to play in the game. 67-51, OCU on top of UCO. Garen Wright will inbound for the Broncos. Stars in a man-to-man defense. Wright looking into Seth Heckert in the right corner. Wright low posted, goes back to Garen Wright, turns and scores. He went right around R.J. McGee, who had to be careful that he didn't pick up his fourth foul. 67-53, OCU on top. R.J. McGee behind the back on the dribble. Now goes between the legs on the right wing. Now explodes to his right all the way to the bucket. Layup high off the glass and in for R.J. McGee. He has 17 points. 69-53. Quickly, here comes UCO. Garen Wright drives right at R.J. McGee. Runs him over, and an offensive foul is called. That's three on Garen Wright. The third team foul on UCO. 69-53 OCU on top. 16:38 to play. Now they have to mop up the floor again after RJ hit the deck. Reggie Sloan is in for the first time, a 5'11", 175-pound junior from Edmund Memorial High School. UCO has a lot of local products on its squad. Jamil Donovan is a local product. He's on OCU's team. He tricks it into the front court, hands it off to Terrence Benome. Top of the key to Inglet. Swing it around left side to R.J. McGee. R.J. drives up to the top of the key. Now stops. Pulls up for three. Missed it off the rim. That was a heat check shot by R.J. Missed. And the rebound to Seth Heckert of UCO. Diagonal pass into the front court to Jones. Jones hesitates. Crosses over to his left. Leans in. Shot blocked by Inglet. Rebounded by Cal Andrews. He's stripped going up, and they're going to call a foul on OCU. That may be R.J. McGee. No. It will be Gary Inglet on the foul. That will be his second and the team's fifth. Cal Andrews will shoot two. Cal had 7 points in the first half. He missed the first foul shot. He's now 2 of 3 foul shooting. ...69-53 our score. Andrews takes aim, shoots the second, missed that one as well. Rebound off the floor, taken by Terrence Benome, and he saves it to Gary Inglet, and here come the Stars on the run. A bounce pass up ahead to R.J. McGee, throws it back into the center. It's saved by Dorian Gigger, out to Jamil Donovan. Three-pointer, got it again! That's three three-pointers for Jamil Donovan in the game. 72-53, OCU on top. They've scored a lot in those scramble situations. Here's Cal Andrews on the left side. Guarded by Gary Inglet, takes a dribble, picks it up, throws it into the post to Bairstow, out to Seth Heckert, high-arcing three, right top of the key, missed. Inglet rebounds for OCU. Outlet pass to Jamil Donovan. Jamil speeds the ball into the front court, now crosses over to his right, kicks it out to R.J. McGee on the right side. R.J. surveys, whips it inside to Dorian Gigger, out to Jamil, right side, three again. Missed it too short this time. Rebound tapped out of bounds by Terrence Benome. It'll be OCU ball, or UCO ball, rather. Trey Jordan returns for UCO. Seth Heckert is out. Stars will apply the backcourt pressure now as Reggie Sloan accepts the inbound pass. He's guarded by Terrence Benome in a man-to-man. Takes the ball into the front court on the dribble, takes it up to the top of the key, drives off to the left, challenges Benome and scores. Nice play by Reggie Sloan. Here come the Stars the other way. Jamil Donovan kicks it out to R.J. McGee, way outside left. R.J. shakes around, now drives, kicks it out. Gary Inglet for three. Missed it short. Rebounded by Jordan of UCO. Here come the Broncos the other way. Sloan drives all the way underneath. Missed the layup. Rebounded by Inglet. Here comes Terrence Benome. A 2-on-3 break for the Stars. Terrence kicks it out to R.J. McGee. Fakes the trailer three. Now drives the paint. Goes to the goal. Missed the layup. Rebound tipped up by Dorian Gigger. That won't go. Next rebound out of bounds. It'll be UCO ball. More point-blank misses for the Stars. It's amazing they're converting the difficult shots and missing the easy ones. And they lead it 72-55 over UCO with 14:42 to play in the second half. Jacob Strassel, Darius Bryson in. It is Bryson, Sloan. Seth Heckert is back in. Garen Wright. That's the lineup for UCO. Theron Chilton and Yvonne Jelincic back in for OCU. Sloan drives on Jamil Donovan. They're going to get Jamil for a hand check foul, and that's six OCU fouls already. And that's three, I believe, on Jamil Donovan. It is. He has 9 points. Jamil was not a scorer his first 2 years, and he's nailed 3 out of 4 three-pointers in this game. UCO inbounding, and the ball stolen away by Gary Inglet on the inbound, but he gives it right back, and a layup by Garen Wright is good. And that'll draw a timeout, a 30-second timeout. 72-57, OCU on top. This has now been converted to a full timeout, so we'll take it. OCU leads UCO. Here on OCUSports.com at Stretch Internet.
What is that?
Oh, that? It's my time machine.
Does it work?
Sure. Just hit this button.
Whoa, dinosaurs. Cool.
Or we can go here.
Hey, that's Napoleon.
Oui.
Or we can go to the future.
Wow. Hey, you have this nice house. Do I have a nice house?
No, you didn't save any money. Always spent it on vacations and stuff.
If only there was a way I could go back in time and correct that bad habit.
Yep.
Okay, the time machine is not real, but the saving thing is. Get in the habit of putting some of your money in savings each week through a 401k, savings account, or financial investments. Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free ideas and easy tips on saving, go to feedthepig.org. That's feedthepig.org.
What does this crazy little button do?
Wait, no!
This message brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
Back at Abe Lemons Arena, the Stars leading UCO 72-57, 14:24 to play in the second half. UCO will have Jacob Strassel, Reggie Sloan, Darius Bryson, Trey Jordan, and Garen Wright on the floor. OCU will counter with RJ McGee, Ivan Jelicic, Jameel Donovan, Theron Chilton, and Gary Inglet on the floor. Inglet trying to inbound against the full court pressure. Nearly threw it away. Saved by Jameel Donovan to Jelicic. Back to Inglet on the break the other way. Bounce pass to Jelicic. Finger roll layup erased, but a goaltend will be called on Trey Jordan. Credit the basket to Jelicic. He has 9 points. Reggie Sloan on the dribble into the front court, 74-57. OCU. Sloan drives off to his left, hands it off to Bryson. Bryson takes it into the paint. Floater from 5 feet is off the glass and in. 74-59. RJ McGee in the backcourt. Throws it up ahead to Jameel Donovan. Jameel a diagonal dribble to his left into the front court. Left side it goes to Theron Chilton. Left alone won't shoot. Stars will use some clock. Gary Inglet has it top of the key. Swing it to RJ McGee. Way outside right. RJ fakes the pass, now throws to Jelicic in the post. Jelicic is fouled from behind by, I believe, Jacob Strassel. That is his first, the team's fourth. OCU will inbound, right baseline underneath. Cal Andrews jumps off the bench to check in. Reggie Sloan is out. Neil Donovan to inbound, does so on a lobby. Jelicic head of the circle to RJ McGee outside left. Right side goes to Jameel, fires it into Jelicic. Jump hook missed. Gary Inglet rebounds for OCU, and he's fouled. Gary Inglet has been everywhere on the boards. There he is. Bryson picks up the foul. That's his first, team's fifth. Strassel is out. Bairstow is in for UCO. RJ McGee to inbound, slaps the ball, whips it inside to Jelicic. His layup is blocked, and the rebound to Bryson. Up ahead to Garen Wright. He drives uncontested for the layup. 11 points for Garen Wright. It's 74-61 OCU, 13:23 to play. Stars have relaxed a little bit. Gary Inglet on the drive, off to his left. Shot is blocked, rebounded by UCO. Here comes Trey Jordan the other way. He's fouled on the drive, apparently, by Theron Chilton. That is his second. That's already the seventh team foul. So for the final 13 minutes and 10 seconds of the second half, UCO will have shots on every foul. Trey Jordan will shoot the foul shots. 2 for 2 foul shooting today for the 6'6", 225-pound junior. Southeast High School in Oklahoma City. He takes aim, shoots the foul shot, makes it. It's down to a 12-point game. Believe the Stars' largest lead was 17. Shoots the second, missed that one short. RJ McGee rebounds for OCU. RJ into the front court for the Stars. Picked up by Cal Andrews. Tries to take him on the drive. Crosses over now. Spins to his right. Missed the layup and the rebound to Trey Jordan of UCO. Stars trying to get too cute. Lob pass knocked away. It's loose in the backcourt. Taken back by UCO. Theron Chilton had a foot on it. And here comes UCO. Bryson's pass goes underneath the legs of Bairstow and out of bounds. That was an ugly sequence of basketball on both sides. OCU will come out with the basketball. Evan White will jump into the game for the Stars. Evan is in for RJ McGee. Terrence Benome is in. Jameel Donovan is as well. Backcourt pressure applied. Jelinčić inbounds to Theron Chilton. He's run out with a double team. Jump passes to Inglet in the front court. Inglet fires it to Terrence Benome. Open right side. Three-pointer. Missed it short. Rebounded by Bryson of UCO. Outlet pass to Garen Wright. Wright drives the right side. Crosses over. Fouled on the drive. Bites Theron Chilton. And more foul shots coming for UCO. Garen Wright, who has 11 points, will try to cut this back down to a 10-point game. Deion Phelps, the Stars coach, talking to the official on the far side. And now OCU wants a timeout. I believe this will be a 30-second timeout with 12:24 to play in the second half, and OCU leading 74-62. RJ McGee continues to lead the Stars in scoring. He has 17 points, 15 of those in the first half. Terrence Benome has 11, Ivan Jelinčić 9, Gary Inglet 8, Jameel Donovan has 9, Theron Chilton 7, Demma has 4, Dorian Giggers 6. Alec Jones leads UCO with 19 points. He's been on the bench for a while. He comes back in out of this timeout. Garen Wright, who's at the foul line, has 11. Cal Andrews, Seth Heckert, Jared Bairstow with 7 apiece for UCO. Garen Wright will shoot the foul shots. And he makes the first. He has 12 points. Twelve and a half to play second half. UCO has chipped away. Garen Wright shoots the second foul shot. That one is short. Rebounded by Gary Inglet, and he is fouled. Seth Heckert collects the foul. That is his third, team six. So now both teams will be in the bonus from here on out. As that's the final foul that UCO had to give. And they'll apply some backcourt pressure. Jelinčić will inbound. Does so to Terrence Benome. Terrence skips the ball into the front court, behind a screen to his left, hands it off to Theron Chilton. Theron splits the defense, drives to the bucket, missed a shot. Tipped by Jelinčić, won't go. And the rebound to UCO. Outlet pass to Wright, skips the ball into the front court. Bounce pass knocked away, somehow gets to Jones, and he lays it in. And it's a 9-point game, 74-65. Jones has 21. 11:55 to play in the game. Stars need some energy. That has been lacking most of the second half. Gary Inglet, left low post, backing in on Cal Andrews, spins to the left. Left-hand shot is good. Gary Inglet into double figures now with 10 points. He's got a double-double in his first action as an OCU star. 76-55, OCU with 11:42 to play. Heckert, Bairstow, Wright, Andrews, and Jones on the floor for UCO. Bairstow has it between the rings, throws it right side to Jones, to Andrews, head of the circle, one dribble off to his right, hands it back to Jones. Looks inside, nobody there, comes across the screen, now goes behind the back, back to his right, drives into the paint, foul going up, they're going to count the shot, are you kidding me? The foul on Theron Chilton, this is fourth. It's the ninth team foul on UCO, and Marlon Jones will have a chance for a plus one to try to cut it down to an 8-point game. Jones has 23 points. RJ McGee is back. Theron Chilton is out. Jones at the line, shoots the foul shot, missed, rebounded by who else but Gary England. He almost threw away the outlet pass, taken by R.J. McGee. R.J. hesitates, top of the key to England, back to R.J. England gives him a screen toward the top of the key. Now Gary gets it back, drives all the way to the bucket, and he missed the layup. The Stars missed another point-blank shot. Here comes Seth Heckert the other way, falls down on the dribble, lost it, and it goes to R.J. McGee. Stars with a three-on-three break. R.J. goes all the way to the bucket, shot blocked, rebound. England had it for a moment. Now he dives on the floor and saves it to Terrence Benome. Save the possession there, but the Stars only have 25 to shoot. 76-67, OCU with 10:52 to play. Evan White has it way outside, top of the key left, dribbles up between the two circles, throws it back left side to Jelinčić. He throws it to Terrence Benome on the perimeter, gets a screen, bounce pass stolen away by Bairstow, but they'll get Jared Bairstow for a foul coming across Gary Inglet, and Gary will shoot a one-and-one foul shot. That's the first foul on Bairstow, the 7th team foul on UCO. Dema is in, Ivan Jelinčić is out. Gary Inglet has 10 points. He's 0 for 1 at the foul line. He has a 1-1 here. Gary shoots the foul shot, left it short. Dema rebounds for OCU. One dribble jump hook from 5, missed badly. Rebound out of bounds off of R.J. McGee. It'll be UCO ball. Stars will put on some full court pressure. Leading by 9, 76-67. Bairstow trying to inbound, does so to Reggie Sloan, who's back in the game, and he gives it to Jones. Jones splits a double team in the backcourt. Now jogs the ball across the midcourt line, goes all the way underneath the goal. Shot blocked by Dema out of bounds. It'll be UCO ball. .26 on the shot clock. Jones will throw it in for the Broncos. 10:28 to play. Lob inbound to Bairstow, head of the circle. Out it goes to Trey Jordan, throws to Cal Andrews, left wing. Top of the key to Jones. Jones jab steps, backs away, shoots a long jumper that missed. Gary England rebounds. Outlet pass to R.J. McGee, no numbers for the Stars. R.J. jogs into the front court, now explodes to his right. We'll have a foul on the drive on UCO. R.J. buried the shot, but it won't count as Marlon Jones called for the foul, his second. R.J. will have a 1-1. Scoring is stalled in the last couple of minutes. 10:13 to play in the game. It's still 76-67 OCU. R.J. McGee will shoot a 1-1, rather. Sub will come in. Garen Wright will return for UCO, and Jared Bairstow is out. More substitutes run up to the scorers' table, and they'll allow them to come in as well. Bryson and Seth Heckert in. Andrews and Jones will leave. R.J. will have a 1-1, shoots the first, makes it. He has 18 points. He's now 2 of 3 foul shooting in the game. R.J.'s second of the 1-1, crawls in as well. He has 19. 78-67, UCO missed a home run pass. Instead, they're still in the backcourt. Ball knocked away by R.J. McGee. Chased down by Darius Bryson. This should be a 10-second count. Where is it? They get a timeout first. UCO, the coach, Terry Evans, called a timeout from the bench with 25 on the shot clock. Almost a 10-second count. Looks like this is going to be a full timeout with 10:02 to play. And the Stars leading 78-67 over UCO. We'll step aside back after this on OCUSports.com.
Take a look under your bed. Find stuff under there? What about jobs? No? Now try your basement. There's a pair of overalls that, overall, you're not so into anymore. A perfectly good laptop that hasn't seen your lap in months. And even more stuff. But still no jobs? Well, you really have both. See, stuff is defined as household articles considered as a group. Sometimes this stuff is no longer needed. Wait, no longer needed? That can't be right. Because remember those jobs you were looking for? Those are really needed. And they're the stuff inside your stuff. Even inside that winter coat that moved with you to Phoenix. Our job is to unlock those jobs. And it starts when you donate your stuff to your local Goodwill. Here's how we do it.
converted to a 30-second timeout, so we're back with 10:02 to play. 78-67, inbound pass comes into Jordan in the backcourt. He hands it to Seth Heckert. And UCO comes into the front court. Heckert dribbles into a double team. Jump passes out of it. Here's a shot underneath. It's blocked by Dema. Garen Wright took it. Rebound on the floor taken by Terrence Benome. And then he gets it up to Dema and he throws it away. And then Dema commits a blocking foul in the backcourt. How on earth is there no foul as Terrence Benome hit the deck on the rebound? Dema collects a foul, his third. That's the 10th OCU team foul. And two shots coming for UCO. Reggie Sloan will shoot the foul shots. Shoots the first and makes it. 3 points for Reggie Sloan. He didn't play in the first half. 78-68. OCU on top. Shoots the second. Makes that one as well. R.J. McGee accepts the inbound pass. Diagonal pass for Dema. Dema catches it, drives to the goal, and he's undercut and fouled and hits the deck hard. Dema will be at the line for two. Seth Heckert collects a foul. That is his fourth and the team's ninth. We've had 19 total fouls called in the first 10-plus minutes of game action. Dema will make his first trip to the foul line. Shoots the foul shot and makes it. Dema was 6 of 8 foul shooting in the exhibition against Midwestern. OCU on top with 9:42 to play. Dema's second missed, rebounded by Jordan of UCO. Here come the Broncos. Reggie Sloan left side. Throws it to Darius Bryson. Tries to drive. Cut off by Evan White. Looking for Cal Andrews. Finds him, and they're going to get a foul on Dema from behind. That's his fourth. And we'll have two foul shots for Cal Andrews. I tell you what, if they're going to call a foul on every trip down the floor, we're going to be here all night. Cal Andrews has 7 points. He'll shoot two. Missed the first off the back of the rim. No good. Dorian Giger is in. Dema is out. Andrew's second foul shot is short. Rebounded by Dory. Bounce pass to Terrence Benome. He's chased in the backcourt by three defenders now. To R.J. McGee right in front of us. Diagonal pass to Gary Englet. Englet drives, leans in, shot missed, got his own rebound, follow, no foul call, and Gary Englet will be at the line for two. Another foul, this one on UCO, their 10th. Trey Jordan collects his fourth foul. Gary Englet will shoot two this time. Shoots the first, makes it. He has 11 points. Bairstow is in. Mollen Jones is in. OCU. 9:18 to play in the second half. Gary Englet's second foul shot is also good. 81-69. Inbound to Jones, the point guard. Dribbles across the timeline off to his left. Now turns away and back out between the two circles. Crosses over to his left, kicks it out to Sloan, drives into a double team, out to Andrews. Andrews drives, challenges Dorian Giger, shot no, foul called, more foul shots for UCO. That's three on Dorian Giger. Cal Andrews, who just missed two. Steps back to the line for two more. Shoots the foul shot. Missed it short. No good. He's missed three in a row. Darius Bryson is in. Garen Wright is out. Second foul shot is good by Andrews. He has 8 points. R.J. McGee slow dribbling against Darius Bryson. Crosses over now between his legs, drives off to his right, has the edge, leans in, shot no. How's there no foul on that? We'll have a foul on the rebound on UCO. My goodness. Fouls on Bairstow. That's the second on Bairstow, and Gary Inglet will shoot two. Double bonus. Makes the first. He has 13. Six fouls called total in the game so far. Inglet makes the second. We still have 8 minutes and 51 seconds to play. 83-70 OCU. Starts with his own backcourt press now. Bairstow has it. Dribbles off to his right into the front court. Almost walk. Gets it to Bryson. He's in a double team. Pass tip, but gets to its intended target. Now Jones has it, and he's fouled on the drive. He fell down, and they're going to get OCU for a foul. It's on Terrence Benome. It's his third. More foul shots coming for UCO. It's taken about 20 minutes to play the last three of game action. That's 13 fouls called on OCU in the second half, 11 called on UCO in the half. He missed the first at Jones. He has 23 points. He leads all scores. Jamil Donovan will come back in. Terrence Benome is out.
Number three, Jamil Donovan, returning for OCU.
Second foul shot by Jones. He missed that one short. And guess who rebounds for OCU? It's Gary Inglet again. Inglet bounces it to R.J. McGee. RJ into the front court, stops, drives off to his left now, hands it off to Jamil Donovan. Jamil out near midcourt to Dorian Giger on the right wing. Dorian top of the key to RJ McGee. RJ has a step, kicks it off underneath to Gary Inglet. Reverse layup good. That's pretty basketball right there by OCU, and Gary Inglet with 16. Quickly, here comes UCO. Cal Andrews kicks it off underneath. The ball goes out of bounds, off of UCO. Hey, look, two straight possessions without a foul. That'll be a UCO turnover. The Stars lead by 15, 85-70. 8:08 to play. Seth Heckert is back in for UCO. Inglet inbounds it to RJ McGee, who leaps high in the air to get it. Backcourt pressure applied by UCO. Up ahead to Jamil Donovan. Jamil walks the ball across the timeline, center of the floor, and he'll slow it up. Off he goes to his right, back to his left. Dorian Giger, three-pointer. Off the back of the rim, missed. Rebounded by Inglet of UCO. He goes right back up, missed a shot, but he missed his tip-in as well. Dorian gets the next rebound, and he's fouled going up. No, a jump ball is called, and it'll be UCO ball. It usually has to be simultaneous possession for a jump ball to be called. That ball was ping-ponging around all over the place, and they'll award possession to UCO on the arrow. Substitutions in for UCO. Trey Jordan is in. Let's just reset the UCO lineup right now. Trey Jordan, Cal Andrews, Seth Heckert, Garen Wright, and Jacob Strassel in. Strassel trying to inbound with 7:48 to play. He's run out with a double team. Now here's a run-through steal by Jamil Donovan that's tipped by RJ McGee. It's still loose on the floor. That's a jump ball. That's what those look like, and they'll call that one and give the ball back to OCU. Dorian Giger was tied up, I believe, with Jacob Strassel on the ground. As Jamil Donovan came up and made a diving attempt at a run-through steal, he couldn't quite get there in time to collect it. Now I believe there's a conversation as to where the shot clock should be, perhaps. Jonathan Reed will check in for the first time for OCU, a freshman. 5'7", 150 pounds from Powder Springs, Georgia. RJ McGee trying to inbound right baseline underneath. Lobs it out to Dorian Giger. Dorian hands it off to Jamil Donovan. against a 2-3 zone defense. Stars leading by 15, 85-70, 7.5 to play in the second half. No look pass to Gary England at the foul line. Drive shot, no foul called. A blocking foul by this official and a charging foul by that official. What's the call? They'll discuss it, and we'll see what the foul ends up being. The official under the basket had a charge. The official on the opposite sideline had a block. And I would imagine the guy underneath the basket has the right of refusal here. And I'll be honest, it looked like a charge to me from here. I have about the same vantage point as the sideline official. Looks like they're going to take the underneath official, and they're going to be charged to Gary England, I think. They continue to discuss it. We might have a double foul. We do. We have a double foul on Gary England and Jacob Strassel. It's what they call a block charge foul, where they assess a foul to both players. And I believe UCO should have it on the alternating possession. I think. For good measure, I'm going to mark those both team fouls. So that's the third foul on Inglet, the second on Strassel, and UCO will have it. Strassel trying to inbound. Does so to Garen Wright in the backcourt, guarded by Jonathan Reed. Still in the backcourt, they run it in with a double team. Strassel takes it across the timeline, gives it to Cal Andrews, way outside left, one dribble and a three-pointer. Missed it around the rim, no good. Rebound tapped off the glass, taken by Wright, and he lays it in. 85-72 OCU. 7 minutes to play in the game. Doreen Gigger way outside left. Left low post to England. Spins to the baseline. Fakes goes up. Shot blocked. Foul called. And Gary England will be back at the line for two more foul shots. Strassel with a foul, his third. Gary England will be back at the line. He's made four in a row at the line. England takes aim, shoots the foul shot. Around the rim, no good. Shoots the foul shot, makes that one. 86-72. Ivan Jelinčić is in, Gary England is out. Inbound pass to Seth Heckert. Gives it back to Strassel. Now Heckert has it back. Still in the backcourt. Needs to get it across, and he traveled with the basketball. Now they'll say a 10-second count. Either one. Either way, it's a turnover, and OCU will have it back. Great defense. Ivan Jelinčić inbounds to Jonathan Reed. Comes across to R.J. McGee and gives it to Jameel Donovan between the two circles. Jameel hands it off to Reed. Out to McGee, way outside left, 6.5 to play. He's guarded by Cal Andrews. Throws it to Reed, way outside right. Reed directs traffic. He's guarded by Garen Wright. Lob pass to Jelinčić, and it's stolen from behind by Seth Heckert. Here comes UCO in a 4-on-3 break. Heckert goes behind the back on the dribble. Floater over Dorian Gigger is good. A great move by Seth Heckert. That's his first point of the second half. He has 9 points in the game. 86-74 OCU, 6:07 to play in the game. Stars will run some clock. RJ has it way outside left, out Cal Andrews defense to Dorian Gigger. Swinging into the left corner, Jameel Donovan. Jameel drives, got caught in the air, throws it to Dorian. Floating shot off the glass and in. Dorian Gigger has 8 points. 88-74 OCU, 5:50 to play. Heckert into the front court on the left wing. Picks up his dribble, lob pass left low post. Goes through the hands of Trey Jordan. It's stolen by Dorian Gigger. Here comes Jameel Donovan the other way. Hesitates, now drives, no look pass is slapped away out of bounds. He was trying to get it to Dorian Gigger underneath the right side of the hoop. And it was poked away by UCO and out of bounds. It'll be OCU ball with 29 on the shot clock. Jared Bairstow is in. Jacob Strassel is out. RJ McGee will inbound next to his own bench. RJ slaps the basketball, looking for somebody to throw it into. Does so to Jonathan Reed near midcourt. Jonathan throws it to Jameel Donovan, almost a run-through steal by Garen Wright. 20 on the shot clock now. RJ has it, drives off to his right, has a step on Cal Andrews, and Cal is called for a foul. That is his fourth. And the 14th foul whistled on UCO in the second half. Stars have also been whistled for 14. RJ McGee will be at the line for two in the double bonus. He has 19 points. RJ shoots the foul shot, missed it off the side of the rim, no good. Jacob Richardson is in. Trey Jordan is out. RJ's second foul shot is good. He has 20. And we have a foul in the backcourt just as the inbound comes in on OCU. That's the fourth on Jameel Donovan. Seth Heckert will shoot two. Takes aim, shoots the first. Spins out, no good. Theron Chilton, who's been sitting for a while, will jump back in. He has four fouls. He replaces Jameel Donovan, who also has four. Heckert will have one more foul shot. He has 9 points in the game. He shoots the foul shot, makes that one. 89-75 OCU. Stars with it in the backcourt, RJ McGee. They run at him with two defenders. Drives it down the right side, throws it up ahead to Theron Chilton. Stars will reset, run clock. 24 on the shot clock as RJ now just holds it in front of the scorer's table, way outside right. Garen Wright comes up to defend him. He takes a jab step and puts the dribble on. Goes between the legs on the dribble. The five count is not on with 13 to shoot. RJ now has the five count on him. Has a screen from Yelinchich. That backs away into a double team. He whips it down low, intended for Yvonne, and it goes through his hands and stolen by Seth Heckert. Heckert into the front court, right side, goes behind the back on the dribble, challenges Reed, throws it back out to Bairstow. And now to Richardson, who throws it to Cal Andrews. Left wing it goes to Heckert, pass underneath to Richardson, reverse layup, missed! Rebound tapped around, a foul on the rebound on OCU's Dorian Giger. My goodness. Four fouls on Dorian Giger, and more foul shots upcoming for UCO. That is the 16th foul called on OCU in the half. 14 fouls on UCO. Jared Bairstow at the line has 7 points, shoots the first and makes it. Gary Englund is in, Dorian Giger is out. Reggie Sloan is in. Byford is in as well, rather Bryson. 89-76, OCU with 4:36 to play. Bairstow makes the second as well. UCO will apply backcourt pressure. Jonathan Reed will initiate into the front court now. Guarded closely by Reggie Sloan. Takes him on the drive, almost had lost the ball, got it back out to Yelinchich. Yvonne drives, bounces off of Bairstow, now tries to drive again, goes into the paint, will have a foul away from the ball, I think. No, Bairstow will pick up the foul. That's his second. Team's 15th. I mean, what point are we trying to prove here? That basketball is a contact sport? I think everybody already knew that. And Yelinchich will have foul shots. Yvonne makes the first. Puts him into double figures with 10 points. Strassel is in. Trey Jordan is in. 90-77. OCU over UCO with 4:19 to play in the game. Anya Lynchich shoots the second foul shot. That one rolls off, no good, and Jordan rebounds. Outlet pass to Bryson. Speeds the ball into the front court. Lost the ball. It's kicked away by Yelinchich and taken by Reed of OCU. Here come the Stars. RJ McGee backs away, shoots a 15-footer and nails it. 22 points for RJ McGee. 92-77 OCU, 3:58 to play. Darius Bryson into the front court for the Broncos. Head of the circle, it goes to Reggie Sloan. Around the curl to the left. Leans in, draws a foul on Chilton. Theron Chilton is fouled out. And foul shots coming for UCO. Jameel Donovan is in. Reggie Sloan will shoot two. Makes the first. 5 points for Reggie Sloan. 3:51 to play. 92-78. OCU on top. Second one rolls in as well. Englet in the backcourt throws it to RJ McGee. RJ going back and forth with the dribble, needs help. Jump passes to Jameel Donovan. Jameel drives, no look pass to Gary Englet. He's going to be called for traveling as he went into the bucket. He made a nice spinning layup and was probably fouled in the process, but he traveled before that. Seth Heckert is in. Darius Bryson is in. Cal Andrews is in. Jacob Richardson is out. 3:39 left. Inbound to Heckert, double teamed in the backcourt. Takes the dribble, picks it up, and a foul in the backcourt on OCU, and more foul shots coming. Gary Englet with his fourth. Seth Heckert back to the line. He hasn't been good from there. He's 50%, I believe. He makes the first here. He has 11 points. Shoots the second. Missed it short. Englet rebounds. RJ McGee splits a triple team into the front court. Explodes. Now runs over the defense, and an offensive foul is called. And I believe that's four on RJ McGee. All right, so RJ has four. Gary Englet has four. Jameel Donovan has four. Dema Sine has four. Terrence Benome has three. Theron Chilton is out. Evan White, one. Ivan Jelincic, two. Dorian Giger, four. Stars have a couple of players on the bench who haven't come in yet. Evan Doremus and Caleb House. 92-80 OCU. 3:28 left in the game. Seth Heckert in the backcourt, and the double team picks up his dribble across the timeline. It comes to Reggie Sloan on the right side. Sloan crosses over behind the back, almost stolen by Jameel Donovan. He's upset that he couldn't get it. 3:17 left. He continues to shake around on the dribble. Now he pulls up for three. Top of the key, missed it short. RJ McGee rebounds. Stars want to slow it up and run as much clock as possible before they decide to call another foul. That's inevitably coming. Reed way outside. Center of the floor now to RJ McGee. Left side to Jameel Donovan. Left baseline to Gary Englet. Gives it back to RJ, 16 to shoot. RJ drives and a hand check foul on Cal Andrews. And Cal Andrews has been disqualified. So foul shots coming for RJ McGee in the double bonus. Jacob Richardson is in. RJ's foul shot is good. 23 points. Substitutes coming in for UCO as Garrett Kilborn is in. Logan Thielen is in as well, the 7-footer. Short on the second foul shot by RJ. 93-80 with 2:47 left. Richardson speeds into the front court, guarded by Reed, comes across the screen, leans in, almost threw it away, but it went off the fingertips of RJ McGee and out of bounds. Evan Doremus is in for OCU, and I think OCU wants a timeout as well. 32nd timeout. We'll keep it here. So both teams appear to be emptying their bench. Logan Thielen, a 7-footer from Wichita, Kansas, has come in. Should point out that a couple of players that UCO is counting on this year, I believe they're counting on anyway, Phillip Brown and Corbin Byford, not able to go in the game today. Byford is a transfer from Oral Roberts from Velma. Richardson has it. Back in play for UCO. Top of the key to Strassel. Fakes the three. Got away with a walk. Now leans in. Layup good. Second basket for Jacob Strassel. 2:20 to play. 93-82 OCU. Jamil Donovan to RJ McGee. Way outside left. Ricky Roberts comes up to defend him. Takes the ball out center of the floor. 15 on the shot clock. Coming up on the two-minute mark of this one. RJ just continues to dribble way outside right now with 8 seconds left. Pulls up and shoots for three, and he nails it. Why not? 26 points for RJ McGee, 96-82 OCU. Minute 45 to play as Richardson into the front court for UCO, guarded by Jamil Donovan man-to-man. Has a screen from Thalen, uses it, shoots for three. Rimmed out, no good. England rebounds again for OCU. Minute and a half to play. It's academic from here. 96-82 as Jamil Donovan just holds near midcourt. UCO does not defend. Good offensive game by OCU today. Marred by the foul calls throughout the second half, but regardless, a good show put on by the Stars as RJ splits the defense. And just for good measure, they'll call a foul on UCO. I think they're going to get Ricky Roberts. That is his first. How did he get away with that? RJ McGee has 26 points. He's at the line now. Makes first. Makes a second as well. Minute 9 to play. 98-82 OCU. UCO with it. Garrett Kilborn has it way outside left. Takes it behind a double screen to the top of the key. Explodes to his right. Shot blocked by Gary England out of bounds. Caleb House is in. Dorian Giger is in. Gary England, RJ McGee go out. They were the stars tonight. RJ with 28 points. Gary England with 17 and I haven't counted the rebounds yet as UCO throws away the inbound pass and OCU will have it with 54 seconds left. Stars will hold the basketball. Just dribble out the final minute of the game here. 23 on the shot clock. We'll see if OCU tries to go to the basket or if they just accept a shot clock violation here and give it back to UCO. Be about a 20-second difference right now. Jamil drives, kicks it out to Jonathan Reed. Back to Jamil. Jamil will chuck a three from the left side, missed off the back of the rim. Kilborn had the rebound for a moment. And, just in case we forgot, here's a foul. That's on Evan Doremus. It's his first. Team's 20th of the half. Kilborn shoots the first of two and makes it. Second one spins out, no good, and Dorian Giger rebounds. 20 seconds left. Stars can dribble it out. 98-83. A great performance by OCU tonight. Showcasing some new players. Should be an exciting season for OCU this year as Jamil Donovan dribbles it out. And that's the final score. Stars win it 98-83 over UCO. Step aside, final game stats. Hopefully we'll talk to Dion Phelps as well. Back after this on OCUSports.com.
Ever wonder what makes us, the Smurfs, so happy? The forest, of course. This is where we, along with the beautiful forest creatures, make our home with beautiful plant life, clean water, and endless adventures. It's a place to celebrate. So discover the forest with your family today. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
So I'm a cat, and I just moved in with this new human, and she's got this little toy she's always playing with, all day long. Tap, 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 bleep, bleep. She can't put it down. There it is. Oh, and get this. She even talks to it. Last week, she asked it for Chinese, and guess what? Egg rolls showed up, like magic. Humans have cool toys.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
Getting your child home safely.
Tap your heels together 3 times.
Is just a click away.
There's no place like home.
But making sure your child is in the right seat is just one of the steps down the road to safer travels.
I don't know how it works.
Find the right seat for your little one's age and size. There's no better way to get home safely. Know for sure that your child is in the right seat.
How can I ever thank you enough?
Get all the facts at safercar.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
There's hundreds of fun and simple things you and your family can do to live a healthier lifestyle. Here's 20 of them. Eat less, eat slower, eat smarter, eat your fruits and veggies, stop eating before you're full, up your fiber, lower your calories, get off the bus early, do some gardening, do jumping jacks, take the stairs, take one, not two, take on a new sport, take a long walk home, walk instead of drive, bend, stretch, reach for the stars, climb the monkey bars, skip the fudge bars. Search We Can online to find more ways you and your family can get healthy together. A message from the Ad Council, HHS, and NIH's We Can program.
Unexpected reactions to smart financial decisions brought to you by FeedThePig.org.
Well, I finally did it. I opened a 401k.
So you're giving up? Just like that?
Giving up on what?
On getting an inheritance from a distant relative.
Don't you think if there were a billionaire in the family, we'd know about it by now?
Listen to me. We are one phone call away from riding horses on our own private polo grounds. One call from christening yachts, having a butler, using summer as a verb.
How do you figure?
Look, everyone's got a rich uncle somewhere. It's statistics. So the best thing you can do is just prepare for the inevitable.
Right, which is why I thought maybe it would be smart to take control of my finances. You know, start using a budget, get out of debt, set some retirement goals.
Budgets? Debt? You watch your mouth. Retirement shouldn't be a goal for us. It should be a way of life.
When it comes to financial stability, don't get left behind. Get tools and tips for saving at feedthepig.org. This message brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs and the Ad Council.
Confessions of a Potentially Perfect Parent, brought to you by AdoptUsKids.org.
I don't know how to talk like a parent. Don't make me come back there. You see what I mean? It's pretty awful. Try it again. Don't make me come back there. Now that's pretty good. That one kind of sounded like my dad. Weird.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you. Call 1-888-200-4005 or visit AdoptUsKids.org for more information. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt Us Kids, and the Ad Council.
Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. At 6, I make his breakfast. Every day I wake up at 5 to give Dad his medicine. At 6, I make his breakfast. At 7, I shower. Every day I wake up
at... For those caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love. Visit aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Uh-huh.
Well, I noticed dry brush where we wanted our bonfire and suggested we move it. Then Smokey Bear showed up and hugged me.
So you noticed some wildfire hazards and moved your bonfire to a safer location.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Smokey, all right. Just letting you know you did good.
Hey, guys, that was Smokey. You owe me 20.
Well, congratulations and thanks for calling. There are many ways to prevent a wildfire. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service, Ad Council, and your state forester.
My name is Ruth Roosie. I'm a retired teacher. I'm 91 years old, and this is how I live United. I say retired, but not really. Once a week, I read books to children as part of United Way's education program. Reading to a child creates links between language and literacy. It creates a bond between grown-up and child. And believe it or not, it prepares them for a better academic future. Oh, we read about frogs and flies and pigs with wings, all sorts of juicy stuff. It's a joy to watch all those little faces. I figure I have the time and they have the need. And I've always believed that if we're not here to help each other, then what are we here for, really? My name is Ruth Roosie. I help kids prepare to succeed in school. So I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer, live United. Go to liveunited.org, brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
This is a guided meditation on parenting. Begin by finding a comfortable, relaxed position. Let out whatever stress is in your body. It could be from the time you left your daughter's blouse in the dryer too long and it shrunk four sizes, or when you donated her private diary to the public library, or when you thought chaperoning the school dance meant actually dancing in the school dance. Whatever it is, let it go. The fire you started with that experimental dinner, let it go. The time you drove away from the gas pump with the gas pump, let it go. Three, very relaxed. Two, there you go. One.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you. For more information on how you can adopt, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUS Kids, and the Ad Council.
Back at Abe Lemons Arena, the Stars defeat UCO tonight, 98-83, is the final score. UCO was led by Marlon Jones with 20 points. Garen Wright had 16, Seth Heckert 11. Cal Andrews and Jared Bairstow 9 apiece. After that, 6 points by Reggie Sloan, 4 by Jacob Strassel, 3 by Trey Jordan, 2 by Darius Bryson and Jacob Richardson. Single foul shot for Garrett Kilborn. UCO was led in rebounds by 2 players with 7. Bairstow and Jordan each had 7, 5 for Seth Heckert. UCO also had 7 dead ball rebounds. That is rebounds that are claimed by not an individual person. UCO with only 8 assists in the contest total. Seth Heckert had 3 of those. 5 different players with 1 assist in the game. 3 steals by Heckert as well, 2 by Bairstow. UCO did record 11 steals in the game, 4 blocked shots, 2 by Trey Jordan. They had 19 turnovers, 8 assists on 26 made baskets, 26 of 56, that's 46% shooting. Just 4 of 17 from 3, they were 27 of 45 at the foul line. OCU, 4 players in double figures for the Stars. R.J. McGee led the way with 28 tonight. Gary Englund had 15 points. Ivan Jelinčić, 12. Terrence Benome, 11. Jameel Donovan, 9 on 3 of 5 three-point shooting. Dorian Giger had 8 points. Theron Chilton had 7 in limited action before fouling out of the game. He was the only player for OCU to foul out. And only one player fouled out for UCO. That was Cal Andrews. Gary Englund led the way with 20 rebounds tonight. The Stars out-rebounded UCO 49-41. Dema had 6 rebounds. Dorian had 5. 7 assists by Jameel Donovan. 2 steals by Theron Chilton. 3 blocked shots by Dema. Now we have Stars head coach Dion Phelps. And, Coach, This was a fun game if you like free throw contests.
Oh, I know. I know. I guess everyone is still trying to adjust to the new rules. And I say new, but those rules were instituted last year, being able to stay on the ball, defend on the ball without fouling. And so, as you see, I think over the country, it's been a foul shooting type of competition throughout the year. But I think the referees are doing a great job. We just have to adjust.
You got a couple of nice performances today. R.J. McGee had 28 points. Gary Englert with 15 points and 20 rebounds today. Gary's a menace underneath, isn't he?
You know, he is. He is. He's relentless. And I think when that starts to happen, it's contagious. And it's one of those things that, as you know, last year we needed. We needed a guy that can be really relentless on the glass. And hopefully he can keep that up all year. It's his personality, so I expect him to do that. And I think Dorian is about the same.
R.J. McGee with the big offensive night. He had 5 3-point shots, most of those coming in the first half. He caught fire in the first half, and you guys pretty much shot really well overall. It seemed like you were making the difficult shots but missing the easy shots.
Oh, I know. I know. I think some of those guys, if you look at it, this was Gary's first night, and he missed a couple of chippies when he's right at the cup. He needs to finish those. But I think that happens when you're rushing. You hadn't been out there on the court for a couple of scrimmages, and now he's back. So hopefully we'll start finishing, and I know we will. I just think our guys, getting a little bit of a rush. But, UCO, I mean, every year they're talented, and every year they're strong. And so making those chip shots every once in a while are a little difficult because they're going to put a body on you, and they're going to let you know they're there.
You guys shared the ball very well as well. 24 assists tonight on 34 made baskets. Is that going to be a staple this year?
I hope so. One of the things that we preach is just sharing the basketball and sharing that passion of what we do on the basketball court and trying to help each other look better. I do hope so. I really do.
The bottom line is you got up 75 shots tonight to their 56. Many more shot opportunities for your team tonight. And it seemed like you guys like to play at a fast pace. Is that true?
You know what? We kind of have to a little bit. In order to try to take advantage of our speed and our length and the guys running the floor. So I hope this is a tone. I just think, tonight it was one of those nights that it happened. But when you got guys like JD that can really push the basketball, you better run if you want to be able to get a pass from them. You got to get out in front of them. And so I think he's the one who kind of sets the tone and the tempo for us. So we'll see. We'll see where we are.
It also seems like you have quite a few players that you're comfortable bringing the ball up the floor and initiating the offense. I mean, you can talk about Jameel Donovan and Terrence Bonneau, both of those in the starting lineup tonight, as well as RJ is capable of doing that as well. And then you brought in Theron Chilton, who did that as well. It's just several players that are very comfortable with the ball in their hands on this team.
You know what? For the exception of RJ, all those other guys have had an opportunity to play point guard at some point in their career. RJ wants to play point badly, so when he gets those opportunities, trust me, he's going to take advantage of it. But it was just kind of something when we were coming down in our offense, that particular offense gives everyone an opportunity if they get the ball to come up and start the offense. So we were fortunate tonight. I think we how many turnovers we had? 16, six over what, I would like. And if we can keep the turnovers down, I wouldn't have a problem with it. But if those guys start turning the ball over, get the ball to the guy who needs to bring it up. But we were fortunate this evening.
Did you see an improvement from the game against Midwestern into this game?
You know what? We did, of course, I mean, we went down there and got our tails whipped, but the same things were present. There was just a situation where I think at Midwestern State they had an advantage. They had a size advantage that we had not seen. When you're talking about 6'9", 265, there wasn't really much we could do with that big joker. And, I mean, he's talented, and he has a lot more girth than what we have been used to. And so every time he touched the ball, it was hard to stop him. And so they shot a high percentage inside. But everything that we did last night against Midwestern State, we had the opportunity to do tonight. Tonight, the ball fell, and RJ had a good night. That was a little bit different. But we're getting better each day, and hopefully we can continue that trend.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Stars win it tonight 98-83 over UCO here at Abe Lemons Arena. That will do it for us. Thanks for tuning in across the OCU Sports Network tonight. Again, the final score, 98-83, OCU over UCO in Game 1, the official Game 1 of the 2014-2015 season. That'll do it for us tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Andrew Himes. We'll talk to you next time on the OCU Sports Network.